Ano ba itong tinatawag na no credit loan, 'di ba? Pwede bang gamitin niya ng mga first-time home buyers, 'di ba? Kung iisipin mo. 'Yan ang mga sample ng mga question na pag-uusapan sa Q&A dito sa Get Real. Asan na yung bola ko?
Hello, K-Nation. It's Robin Ning. Ning, we're in our office here in Concord. Mm-hmm. And we have some questions that came in to our staff.
Right.
And so we're going to do some Q&A on some different topics that people have out there.
Right. So, ang unang tanong natin is from Erica of San Francisco. Gusto kong makabili ng bahay if ever magiging first-time home buyer ako. Maaari ba kung ma-qualify sa no credit loan na dati nating pinag-usapan sa Get Real?
Of course, you can buy a home with a no credit loan. But my suggestion be to use those loans as a bridge loan. Don't use that as permanent financing. But you can. But first, for Erica, you know, you want to see how your credit really is.
Right.
Because, you know, on no credit loan, 30% down payment,
right.
Higher interest.
Right.
If their credit is good, right, they could do things like the 5% grant, which is no down payment types of loans. Mm-hmm. And you know, you don't really need money for down payment.
Right.
The interest rates are good. Mm-hmm. And you don't, you know, you just need good credit for those.
Yeah. So, ang no credit po kasi, yun po yung programa na hindi po kinakailangan ng good credit, hindi kinakailangan ng income, walang income verification, employment verification. Ang kailangan lang po nun is 30% down payment. That's why yung pong interest rate niya is a little higher.
Yeah.
This one is from Raquel of Chicago. Meron akong investment property na merong equity, but hindi ako nakakakuha ng magandang cash flow from it. Anong alternative ang pwede kong gawin?
Unless you see really strong appreciation, sometimes it's best to sell, and you can do what's called a 1031, where really, instead of paying taxes, you're reinvesting that tax deferred into another property where you can get cash flow. It's very common. It's a great way to build net assets and value and net worth.
And in fact, we have the same scenario po na itong client na to, isang property niya sa San Francisco. We did a 1031 na ngayon po is naging apat yung kanyang real estate investment. So, there are a lot of ways po paano natin mapapalago yun pong ating real estate investments. We just need to be careful doon sa gagawin po because yung pong 1031 na sinasabi ni Robert is time sensitive and you need to have a plan even before you touch the investment property to be sold. So, ang third question is si Nate ng Southern California. Tumawag siya 3 years ago sa atin at ang ating advice sa kanya is mag-short sale siya because he is underwater. Pero he decided not to kasi nag-intay siya na tumaas pa yung kanyang equity. And so, now it took 3 years na mukhang hindi naman tumaas yung value ng kanyang property. And then my loan modification rate is adjusting. So what can I do now?
Yeah, unfortunately, some people who waited through those times regained some equity and they were able to get out. But if you're in a certain area where it did not come back to where you were before, you're still underwater and you've spent a lot of time making payments and maybe you had lower payments with your modification
before
and as the fifth year kicks in, right, you're back going back up again. You're being faced with short sale, right, because it's very painful to pay higher than rental rates for your home to keep a home that is still underwater.
Right.
Never too late to get rid of bad debt. Probably maybe better before because you would be further down, and we told people that. But if you're still underwater, consider short sale, get rid of it. There's programs to recover quickly. I would suggest, you know, don't keep, you know, throwing good money after bad.
That's right. So it's never too late po. Kasi at least ngayon nare-realize natin na, okay, it's been 3 years and I'm still underwater.
Yeah.
We just need to move on. Kumbaga parang there's no time to regret. Ang mahalaga po is kung ano yung ating magiging future life para po sa ating family.
That's true.
So keep sending your questions po, and we'd love to answer those. And mainam din po na magkausap po tayo. You can visit our website and you can schedule po your pre-consultation with either Robert or Ning.
Or they can call us, Ning, at 888-860-9530 or visit us online. So, from Robin Ning, until next time, bye!